as the victors. Stand with Noxus and be remembered forever. Hello everybody, and welcome to League of Legends ASMR lore reading. 皆さんこんばんは。今日はダリウスのロアを読みます。No greater symbol of Noxian might than Darius, the nation's most feared and battle-hardened leader. Rising from humble origins to become the hand of Noxus, he cleaves through the Empire's enemies, many of them Noxians themselves. Knowing that he never doubts his cause is just and never hesitates once his axe is raised, those who stand against the commander of the Triferian Legion can expect no mercy. Darius, the hand of Noxus.
They will regret opposing me.
Darius and his brother Draven grew up as orphans in the port city of Basilisk. Some soldiers do in a lifetime. After Basilisk was seized by the expanding Noxian Empire, the victorious commander Cyrus saw the strength in these defiant brothers, and they found a home within the ranks of his war host. Over the years, they fought in many grueling campaigns of conquest from one end of the known world to the other, as well as crushing a number of rebellions against the throne. Within the Empire, anyone could rise to power, no matter their birth, culture, or background, and none embraced this ideal more fervently than Darius. From humble beginnings, he rose steadily through the ranks, always putting duty before all else, and garnering great respect for his aggression, discipline, and refusal to ever take a backward step. On the blood-soaked fields of Talamore Plain, he even beheaded a Noxian general after the coward ordered a retreat. Roaring in defiance and hefting his bloodied axe overhead, Darius rallied the scattered warbands and won a great and unexpected victory against a far more numerous foe. He was rewarded with a senior command of his own, attracting many thousands of eager recruits from across the Empire. Darius turned the majority away, accepting only the strongest, the most disciplined and iron-willed. Such was his fearsome notoriety, even in the lands beyond Noxus, that it was not uncommon for entire cities to surrender at the first sight of his banners. After a grinding victory against the cloud fortresses of the Varju, a proud warrior people who had resisted decades of Noxian aggression, Darius was named the Hand of Noxus by Emperor Boron Darko himself. Those who knew Darius best knew he craved neither power nor adulation. He wished merely was growing weary of endless wars of attrition and returned to Noxus to demand a reconsolidation of the military. He marched his veterans into the capital, only to find that the Emperor was dead, killed in a coup led by Jericho Swain. The act had been supported by many allies, including Darius' own brother, Draven. This was a difficult position. As hand, many of the noble houses would expect Darius to avenge Darkwill, but he had known and greatly respected the disgraced General Swain, and had spoken against the discharge after the botched offensive in Ionia some years earlier. The oath of the hand were to Noxus, not any particular ruler, and Swain was a man who spoke honestly of his new vision for the Empire. Darius realized this was a reader he was prepared to follow, but Swain had other ideas. With the establishment of the Triferics, three individuals would rule Noxus together, each embodying one principle of strength, vision, might, and guile. Darius gladly accepted his place on this council and pledged to raise a new elite force, the Triferian Legion. Most loyal and prestigious warriors the Empire could produce, and lead the armies of Noxus into a glorious new age of conquest. The Winter Spike Road by Laura Mishit. By evening, the snow had soaked all the way through Maja's boots. With each step, she could feel icy water slosh from her heel to her toes, like a flaying knife drawn along her foot. Other soldiers were struggling too. 15 miles downhill in west high snow wasn't easy. But the legionaries at the head of the column weren't limping. Their steps kept the confident rhythm they struck since morning, and their watchful eyes were still glued to the horizon. They probably have better boots, Maja thought. Triferians are tough, but nobody is that tough in standard issue boots. Hey, Zolt muttered, holding up. Zolt, the only Minotaur in the warband, was taller, wider, and older than everyone else. He was plowing a deep trench through the snow on sturdy hooves. Maja was jealous. "Wish I couldn't feel my feet," she said. "If I didn't have feet, no one could make me march." In the last campaign against the Winter's Claw, I saw a soldier's foot freeze solid, Zolt said. His toes cracked off when he put his boots on, so wham, General Darius chopped the whole thing off. Maja turned her gaze down the mountain. On a bend in the road far below, she could see Darius himself, the hand of Noxus, might incarnate. The general's huge axe gleamed on his back. "You're lucky to be here," Zolt told her. "Darius knows this road better than anyone. He built it during Darkwill's campaign, and we can help him take it back." A little lick of anger burned in Zolt's eye. Damned Winter's Claw. Cliffs rose sheer on either side of Darius's mountain road. Looking up, Maja could see the silhouettes of soldiers standing atop them. "The scouts don't get a rest, do they?" she asked. "What?" she pointed. "The scouts." "Which scouts?" Zolt asked. Then he looked up too. Whatever curse he bellowed was smothered by the avalanche. Took curtains of white separated from the cliff tops above them. Almost instantly, they filled the pass. Chunks of hard-packed snow smashed into the Noxian column, swallowing the soldiers row by row as the avalanche raced downhill. Maja braced, but it was like being hit by a charging basilisk. There was stumbling terror, an awful weightlessness, then darkness, and the crush of winter. Crunch! Someone heaved Maja out of the snowpack. Get up, he commanded, a voice ringing like the clash of blades. Dig them out! She shook herself and started to dig. Then she realized she was digging beside the general himself.
I will not rest.
Darius found a cloven foot in the snow. Zulp, Maja shouted. She helped the general heave him out. Maja looked back up the frosty slope. Far above, Winter's Claw warriors were picking through the scattered remains of the Noxian dead. No retreat now, Maja thought. Darius was counting heads. Officers, he called. Two Trifarian legionaries swiftly ran over. Report casualties. There's a river over the next ridge. We'll fortify there. Darius surveyed the battered Noxian ranks, his expression burning with barely leashed anger. If you can't walk, crawl. As the pale sun plummeted toward the horizon, Winter's Claw skirmishers followed the Noxian column all the way down to the frozen river, peppering them with barbed arrows. However, the probing fire didn't slow down the disciplined Trifarian legion. Maja's breath grew ragged as she hurried to keep up with them. The frozen river was wide and slick enough to make it a dangerous approach for the Winter's Claw, and by holding the bank, the Noxians knew any attack would have to come from the nearby tree line. In spite of the sporadic fire from the shadows beneath the pines, Darius ordered two snow trenches dug parallel to the bank. Soldiers repurposed shields into shovels, and Maja saw Darius doing the same. Remember this, Zolt said. You saw the Hand of Noxus digging with the infantry. Everyone then sharpened stakes for the outer trench. Darius checked defenses along the line, but stopped at Zolt. You're familiar, he said. I fought in the first Fleordian campaign, general. Zolt nodded at Maja. Told this youngster how much worse it was. Darius looked Maja over. This is your first action, he said. Maja wondered how he could tell. Yes, general. Don't waste time on fear, he told her. Focus on facing the enemy, on putting your blade in their throats. Maja wasn't sure what to say. Something parted the air between them, and a javelin lodged in the wall of the trench. Maja turned toward the tree line. Branches were shaking, blades were shining, and moonlight glinted on polished bone. Stand to, Darius bellowed. As the Noxian scrambled for cover, and another volley of javelins flew from the trees, Maja saw a soldier's dagger, 3 feet of knotty wood, sprouting from his chest. Darius pushed past Maja and Zolt, arrows pinging off the axe on his back. Soon, they'll charge soon, he told them. His eyes were lit with fierce excitement. That's when we'll strike. And just as he spoke, a snarling came from the trees. A pack of six-legged, cat-like shadows raced out of the darkness, trained wild claws leaping for Noxian throats. The Winter's Claw followed. As Trifarian legionaries rose from the trench to meet them, Maja drew her sword. She saw Darius bring his axe down like a guillotine. She rose too, ready to fight, when Zolt collapsed beside her. A javelin was buried in his shoulder. "Go," he gasped, but Maja planted herself beside him. Winter's Claw warriors were on them in an instant, hatchets swinging. Zolt deflected a skull-crushing strike with his good arm, and Maja tripped their attacker. But instead of delivering the killing blow, she turned back to Zolt. She could save him. She had to. She pushed Zolt toward the river, away from the fight, and they slithered out onto the ice behind the Noxian line. As Zolt fell to his knees, struggling for breath, Maja had a sudden urge to flee across the river with him. "Don't," Zolt could tell as she was thinking. "A Noxian never flees." Maja's heart seemed to be beating in her throat. She opened her mouth to argue with Zolt. "I am a Noxian, I am." But her mouth refused to form the words. Then Zolt's eyes widened, and a heavy hand landed on Maja's shoulder. She knew who it was before she turned around. "Face the enemy," Darius growled. "I..." "You're not facing them." With a flick of his arm, Darius spun her on the ice. "Noxians who flee die," he said. "By your hand," Maja knew. "By that axe." As she stared, Darius hefted the axe above his head. And for an instant, Maja thought, "This is it, my execution." But the moment never came. A flurry of arrows ricocheted off the flat of the blade, falling harmlessly around them. And Darius lowered the axe again. "Noxians don't run, we win," he growled. "We chop them to pieces for what they do to us." And suddenly, Maja was angry at the Winter's Claw, and at herself, and at her fear. With jerking, frozen limbs, she shoved Zolt aside. She heard him grunt as he hit the ice, but she left him there, and Darius did too. Beside him, lockstep, she ran into the whirlwind of Noxian steel. Their blades flashed, and Maja swung hers until her muscles burnt and her hand was sore from impact after impact. And with each hammering blow, she reminded herself, "Live, win, chop them to pieces." By sunrise, the Winter's Claw had been routed. When they returned, Darius and Maja found Zolt at the riverbank, his chest prickled with arrows, dead. Maja felt numb. She'd been telling herself, maybe he rallied, maybe he fought, but he just died where they left him. "I was trying to protect him," she told Darius. He was a good soldier. I was trying to protect him." Darius paused. "That was a poor decision," he said. Maja startled. "Sir?" "You should have been fighting alongside soldiers who still had a chance of living." He turned his gaze to Maja. She shuddered. His eyes were like iron. "Old Zolt was ready to die, but you should have been ready to fight." "Yes," she stammered. "I'll sir. Darius turned north toward the dawn-lit slopes of the Winterspike Mountains. Maja could see campfires up there, smoke rising through the trees. The Winter's Claw.